Hello, crafty friends. It's Erica, ScraptyEva29. Welcome back to my channel. I'm coming on today with a quick project share. I recently received the new release from the Andy store, and I was able to cut out this beautiful flower nested frame set. And I also die cut out this tag nested set as well. And it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tags, and it is stitched and scalloped. It's really, really cute. So I'm gonna show you that cut out so you can just see what it looks like. Isn't that flower so pretty? I just cut it out of some different color pink cardstocks and then layered the larger one with the yellow, but wanted to show you how pretty that is. It's gorgeous, right? I did make a project with it, but I did want to show you what it looked like with just some plain cardstock. So that's the flower. And then the tag set looks like this. And again, really, really pretty detail. I'll just pick up a couple so that you can see up close. But there's the stitching and the really pretty scalloped edge. It's adorable. And I love the tiny tag. Isn't that so pretty? And I just die cut it out of that Opal Essence Sizzix paper I just got. I was dying to like cut into it. So that's what I did. Isn't that so pretty? So I cut those tags out of that. I figured I could use these on a project. So I have those cut out of that really pretty cardstock. And then I just cut the larger one out of this gold glitter, which is super pretty as well. So that is the scalloped stitch tag set that's new in his shop. And then another die that I used in my project is this Chaos Craft banner die set. Let me just zoom out just a tad so that you could see. It comes with this larger banner, and the larger banner measures, It measures approximately 5 1/4 inches in the length, and then the width and the length is 7.5 inches. So that's the largest one. So it's a really nice size banner. And then the smaller one measures 3 3/4 by 5 1/4 approximately. And then you get a really pretty stitched butterfly circle and then a plain stitch circle in this particular set. And I hadn't played with this die set yet, so I wanted to play with it. So that's what I used to create my little project. All right, so let me show you what I made. I decided to do a little banner flip book, if you will. And I like making flip books and little books like this as mini albums because they're just so much fun to create. And I love to keep memories of my kids. So what I did was I used these little pink jump rings that I got off AliExpress, just attached some tulle and some ribbon to the top. I may add some more. I hadn't decided because I wasn't sure if I was gonna make more pages, but this is how I decorated the front. So you can see this larger banner. You can see that I have the glitter cardstock cut out and you can see the scalloped edge. And then I went back with the patterned paper and cut it out a second time, but cut off the edge so that it would just be on the inside of the paper, if that makes sense. And then I just use some embellishments from this paper collection. And you see, I have this really pretty butterfly die cut. And then I use that floral die cut right there. That's where I layered it up in the center of this embellishment. I'll get in a little bit closer so you can see. It's all layered up on foam. And I just use some cut aparts and little stickers from this collection. I love the idea of adding sequins and beads. I've been seeing a lot of crafty ladies do that. So I did that right there. And I think it came out adorable. And then on the bottom down here, I also added some sequins just with some glue. And I just thought that looked so pretty. And this is the new collection. Oh my goodness, I can't remember which collection this is. I think this is the color study. I'll link it in the description box below in case you're interested, but it's a really fun, vibrant paper collection. So that is the little first page. And then I did die cut out a couple more just so that you could see what it looks like. And let me just kind of zoom out because this one is really big. So I didn't glue this down, but I just wanted you to see how it's, I cut off the edge and how it lays on top of the one that scallops. See, the scallops are on, and there are perforated lines on the die, so you know where to cut. So I just cut that scalloped off the outer, the first layer of dotted lines, and then you're left with this piece right here. So that's the piece that you would use to layer the banner, if that makes sense. So that's what that looks like. And then I have this page right here. And it's so pretty, this cardstock. So I have the start of my little mini banner album, I'm gonna call it. So I'm loving that. And then I did make a small one, and this is just, it's just an embellishment. It's not an album, but I did use an iridescent straw and these fun little pom-poms. And then I sewed the little strips right here and added my eyelets. I accidentally messed that eyelet up, and I'm gonna try and pull it out, but I didn't wanna mess up my project, so I was like, I'll just leave it. But I layered it with that really pretty scalloped butterfly that comes with that banner set. I'll zoom in so you can see. And then I have the stitched circle right underneath that rosette. And then I have some of the bits and pieces from that collection. And then if you look really closely, I actually added a couple of those tiny little butterflies that fell out of this circle. I put it on the cardstock, and then I used one of my rolled flower metal dies to create those rolled flowers. And I've got a really fun little embellishment ready to go. This would be so cute just to hang on a wall in your crafty space, or gift it, or you could just use it as an embellishment. Whatever your heart desires. But this is the smaller banner. And then, as you can see side by side, the size difference. But they're both amazing. And I love both sizes. So that is my quick little project share for today. Check the description box below for product information. Of course, if you have any questions, just ask. Thanks for stopping by my channel today, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye for now.